好，我諗差唔多啦。歡迎各位出席今日嘅警方嘅記者會。今日記者會咧有三位講者嘅，分別就係喺台上邊中間位置嘅警務處助理處長行動呂錦豪先生，坐喺呂 Sir 右手邊嘅係警務處助理處長特別職務支援郭家全先生，而坐喺呂 Sir 左手邊嘅係警務處港島總區高級警司行動廖家琪先生。三位咧會就6月30日同埋7月1日國家主席習近平出席回歸25周年大會同埋第六屆特區政府就職典禮期間，警方嘅安保行動作出介紹。然後我哋會再接受記者嘅提問。依家我先將時間交俾呂 Sir， 唔該呂 Sir。
OK， 各位記者朋友好啊。國家主席習近平先生咧將出席香港特別行政區成立25周年嘅慶典，以及咧第六屆特區政府嘅就職典禮。警隊咧係會以主席咧來港嘅安排咧，進行一系列嘅安保部署。喺國家主席出席相關活動期間咧，我哋警方咧係有責任採取適當嘅措施咧，去確保佢嘅人身安全，亦都係要確保佢出席嘅慶祝活動咧係能夠喺有序同埋安全嘅情況之下咧進行嘅。國家主席出席活動期間咧嘅保安安排咧，係包括向國家主席咧提供近身嘅保衛，喺慶祝活動嘅場地嘅保安，以及咧佢嘅車隊嘅護送工作。其中重要嘅部分咧，就係喺國家主席逗留啦、到訪啦同埋途經嘅地區咧，就設立核心保安區，而佢周邊嘅範圍咧就列為保安區。因此咧，喺國家主席嘅車隊途經嘅地區嘅行車同埋行人天橋咧，係需要短暫咁封閉嘅。警方會喺現場咧係實施車輛同埋人流嘅管制。國家主席來港期間咧，金鐘同埋灣仔北一帶咧係會受到較大影響嘅，因為咧6月30日到7月1日兩日咧，喺會議道以北會議展覽中心半島將會封閉，屆時咧出入半島嘅人士同埋車輛咧係會受到管制同埋保安檢查。另外，港鐵會展站咧屆時亦會係暫時封閉。警方相信咧，到時灣仔北一帶咧嘅交通係會非常擠塞，所以咧我喺度呼籲咧駕駛人士，如無必要咧，應該盡量避免咧駕車駛入有關嘅地區。若然咧係要駕車進入呢啲地方嘅時候咧，請保持忍讓，並咧係聽從喺現場嘅警務人員指示。我哋警方咧亦會透過警區嘅警民關係組，向相關地區嘅團體商户去解釋今次咧國家主席出席活動而採取嘅特別安排。接住咧，我就想講明一下喺今次有關限制飛行區嘅安排。一如以往啦，由於飛行服務隊咧同埋我哋警隊咧，在這個安保行動期間呢，是有十分頻繁的飛行任務，所以呢民航處呢會將於在維港兩岸以及呢某些地區呢是設立這個臨時的限飛區，限制呢一般的飛機和其他的飛行裝置呢是飛行的。至於小型無人機方面呢，警方咧經過謹慎審視風險評估之後咧，將會根據新嘅法例第448G章小型無人機令嘅第19条所授予嘅權力，喺國家主席出席活動期間咧，將會喺全港嘅範圍列為小型無人機嘅限飛區。市民咧請密切 留意民航署的 SUA 一站通，以获取有关的限飞区资讯。我们警方呢一向都尊重市民和平集会的权利的。虽然截至今日为止，我们还未收到在国家主席出席活动期间有任何公众集会活动的申请，但是呢我们都会在保安区外就预留指定的公众活动区。如有公众活动呢，可以在指定的公众活动区里面进行的。市民呢亦都可以在我们警方设置的递信区递交请愿信。我们警方在这里呼吁呢，参与公众活动的人士除了要遵从在现场警务人员的指示之外呢，亦都是需要遵守呢所有防疫相关的规定，以免违法。至于采访安排，警方是会根据保安的要求以及场地限制等因素，在不影响警方行动的前提下，我们一如以往会尽量为传媒提供协助和便利。我们警方是完全明白有关的保安措施、交通安排、临时限飞区的设立或多或少都是会对市民造成不便的，但是警方是已经评估了不同的因素的风险，在确保这个安保行动在安全有序进行到的大前提下作出平衡，希望市民能够谅解和支持。警方再次重申，我们是绝对不会容忍任何暴力或者违法的行为，更加不会容忍警方的安保行动是受到干扰或者破坏。如发现任何危害生命、财产、破坏公共安全、公共秩序的行为，我们一定会采取果断的执法行动。有关交通的改道、封路的细节等，稍后港岛总区高级警司行动廖家琪先生就会向大家讲解，之后呢再由助理处长特别职务郭家全先生为大家讲解一下关于传媒采访的详细安排。我们今天用英文再讲一次。 Now I will recap in English. The President of the People's Republic of China, Mr. Xi Jinping, will attend a number of official and celebration events relating to the 25th anniversary of the establishment of the Hong Kong SAR. He will also officiate the inauguration ceremony of the sixth term government of the Hong Kong SAR. Police would implement a series of security measures when our president visits Hong Kong. During the event, police is duty bound to ensure the personal safety and security of our president, and to ensure the official events that he will attend and other related functions are conducted in a safe, orderly, and secure manner. To achieve this, police needs to put in place a series of security measures, such as providing motorcade escorts and personal protection to our president, ensuring the venue security of the official and celebration events that he will attend, and setting up core security zones at the venues where our president stays, visits, and passes by, and the security zones outside the venues. Road closures, temporary traffic, and pedestrian diversions will be put in place, including temporary closure of footbridges and flyovers during the passage of our president's motorcade. Admiralty and Wan Chai North area will be affected the most during the visit. Between 30th of June and 1st of July, Hong Kong Exhibition and Convention Center Peninsula to the north of Convention Avenue will be closed. All guests and vehicles entering the area will be subject to security screening. The Exhibition Center MTR station will be temporarily closed. It is believed traffic congestion is very likely in Wan Chai North area. I would like to appeal to motorists not to drive to these areas. If you really need to do so, please be patient and comply with the direction of our officers at scene. Police community relations officers of the affected districts will provide advice to local and neighborhood groups on the impact of the arrangements. I would also like to talk about the restricted flying zones arrangements. As usual, there will be frequent flying tasks deployed by the government flying service and police throughout the security operation. Civil Aviation Department will therefore designate temporary restricted flying zones in the vicinity of Victoria Harbour and several designated areas. Aircraft and flying objects will be restricted from entering the area. As for small unmanned aircraft, after a careful review of the risk assessment, the entire area in Hong Kong will be temporarily designated as a small unmanned aircraft's restricted flying zone by virtue of the authority under the new regulation, Section 19 of the Small Unmanned Aircraft Order, Chapter 448G, during the visit of our president. Members of the public, please pay close attention to the electronic portal of the Civil Aviation Department's website for further details of the restricted flying zones. Police fully respects the people's rights to public meetings and processions. As of today, police had not yet received any notification from any organization of the intention to hold public events during the period of our president's visits. However, we will reserve a designated public activities area outside the security zone and facilitate members of the public to hold public meetings. Members of public can also present petition letter to the forward at the forward petition area. We appeal to people who would take part in public events to comply with the instructions of our officers at scene and to comply with the latest anti-epidemic and social distancing requirements in accordance with the relevant regulations. Police will consider a number of factors such as geographical limitations and security measures when formulating press arrangements. As long as police operation is not undermined, we, as usual, will do our best to offer assistance as to facilitate the work of media. Police is fully aware that the security measures, traffic arrangement, and temporary restricted flying zone may cause a certain degree of inconvenience to the community. However, such arrangements were implemented after assessing different risk factors, and we are duty bound to ensure that the security operation will be conducted in a safe and orderly manner. I would like to appeal to all members of the community for their understanding and support. To conclude, I would like to repeat that police will not tolerate any acts of violence or public disorder, and will not tolerate anything that may interfere and undermine the security operation. In any event that any person behaves in a manner that threatens life or property and undermines public order or endangers public safety, we will take resolute actions. Senior Superintendent Mr. Stephen Liu of Operations Hong Kong Island Region will now cover the detailed arrangement of traffic diversion and road closure. Later, Assistant Commissioner of Police Special Duty Mr. Kenneth Guo will give further details of the press arrangement. Thank you.
唔該曬，女士。咁大家好，我會接落嚟咧講一講就回歸25周年慶典啊，喺港島區嘅一啲特別交通安排嘅細節嘅。咁因應保安需要啦，咁警方咧其實會喺舉辦慶典活動嘅周邊範圍啦，亦都係特別係嘉賓車隊行車路線同埋佢所行經嘅行車或者行人天橋咧實施一管制，並且咧喺有需要嘅時候咧會作出封閉嘅。具體安排可以看看我身後展示的地圖先。在灣仔北路段一帶，其實我們的交通封路的措施，我們主要是會分為兩個階段。第一個階段會由6月29日的凌晨2點鐘開始，即是說今晚去到凌晨2點鐘，會展半島所有的道路，包括博覽道、博覽道東、博覽道中、會議道、菲林明道的一些部分的路段，菲林明道天橋北行線屆時都會是封閉的。同時中環灣仔繞道前往灣仔北、龍和道東行往中環灣仔繞道和龍和道的部分路段亦都是會封閉的。而在接近中區一帶的路段，包括龍合街、龍景街、耀星街咧，屆時咧亦都係會封閉嘅。咁即係咧，大家見到喺圖裏邊咧，紅色嗰啲路段。咁除此之外咧，途中咧綠色嘅路段，咁亦都咧係會喺行動期間咧間歇咧係封閉。咁當中包括嘅路段咧係有菲林明道、港灣道、分域碼頭街同埋分域街嘅一啲部分嘅路段。第二階段就會由6月30日晚的凌晨1點鐘開始關閉港鐵會展站，亦都是途中黃色的部分。在關閉會展站期間，其實東鐵線是會正常行駛的，只不過它不會停會展站，意思就是說乘客不能夠在這個站上車或者下車，而是需要去到金鐘站的。就我剛才所講到呢一啲特別嘅交通安排，我明白咧係會對市民造成一定嘅不便。首先咧就係喺封閉期間咧，如果需要進出會展半島嘅人同埋車輛咧，係會受到管制同埋需要進行一啲保安嘅檢查。而出入會展辦公室大樓嘅人，亦都係同樣咧需要接受保安嘅檢查嘅。其次咧就係對駕駛人士嘅一啲影響，咁我哋會留意到啦。咁而家喺途中有三條藍線，咁首先咧喺右手邊由東邊過嚟會議道西行嘅車輛咧，咁首先咧佢係要駛入去會展站無名路啦，然之後再駛落去菲林明道嘅藍行線。咁再者咧喺低少少，我哋會見到菲林明道嘅北行線，當佢駛到去港灣道嘅時候咧，佢係必須要轉左或者轉右啦。另外咧就係龍和道東行嘅車輛咧，係必須要右轉進入天華道嘅南行線。咁警方同埋運輸署咧，會喺現場咧係會增加多啲指示咧，務求咧令到咧係大家能夠有多啲嘅一啲信息可以睇得到。咁亦都咧喺到時咧，如果視乎情況咧，我哋亦都可能會加入其他嘅一啲措施嘅，咁所以駕駛人士咧要更加留意啦，小心忍讓，同埋跟從我哋在場警務人員嘅指示，係避免發生意外。咁公共交通服務安排方面啊，咁我哋見到其實喺會展站嘅公共交通交匯處啦，咁係將會封閉，咁亦都係圖中黃色所顯示會展站中間嗰個位置。咁當中咧有18條喺上址嘅巴士路線咧係會受到影響。 其中有11條的巴士路線總站呢是會搬到去灣仔南，亦即是內告士打道、莊士敦道和軒尼斯道一帶的。咁其餘受影響的巴士路線的總站就會遷移去到金鐘巴士總站、天后，又或者咧會係改為一些循環線咧係不停站。另外咧有22條巴士路線係將會咧改行咧就唔會經過灣仔北一帶嘅。咁公共運輸嘅機構咧，其實佢會喺沿途啦，亦都會加入一啲張貼一啲告示啦，咁啊通知乘客呢一啲特別嘅安排。咁駕駛人士咧，亦都需要留意啦，運輸署透過唔同嘅媒體發放嘅一啲最新嘅交通改道嘅措施。咁呢一啲嘅路線咧，咁希望大家之後咧可以再留意翻運輸署所發出嘅運輸署公告。咁另外咧，由6月28日晚，即係今晚10點開始咧，喺呢一個範圍以內嘅一啲停車咪標位啦、上落客區啦、停車位咧，亦都會係暫停使用嘅。咁當中係包括有龍和道、龍匯道、港灣道、會展站無名路、龍合街、天華道、天美道同埋紅興道。咁市民咧要緊記，如果你係停泊咗車輛喺上述呢一啲地方咧，記得喺今晚之前咧要駛走啦。違例嘅車輛咧將會被檢控啦，亦都係會被即時拖走，而不予事前嘅警告嘅。咁由於灣仔北一帶咧，大家見到呢啲特別嘅交通安排，咁我哋相信港島咧特別係會影響到中環、金鐘、灣仔、銅鑼灣一帶咧，都會係非常之繁忙嘅。咁警方呼籲啦，市民應該盡量利用公共嘅交通工具啦。如果有需要駕駛嘅人士咧，亦都一定要保持忍讓，遵從在場嘅警務人員指示，亦都要同時咧留意最新嘅一啲交通嘅安排嘅。咁我哋明白到咧，呢一啲安排對市民係會帶嚟不便啦，特別係喺灣仔北一帶。咁市民咧可能係需要行多少少，等多一陣。咁而今次咧喺5年之後，國家主席能夠出席慶祝香港回歸25周年嘅咁重大嘅日子啦，希望市民能夠多啲包容同埋體諒，亦都咧全賴大家嘅合作同埋配合啦。警方一定會盡力咧將呢個影響咧減到最低，亦都咧係確保所有活動咧係安全有序地進行嘅。咁我報告到呢度。
咁啊，跟住就係就住嗰個傳媒採訪嘅安排。咁啊，國家主席咧預計係會來港出席香港特區成立25周年嘅慶典，以及咧第六屆特區政府嘅就職典禮。警方咧係有責任去採取保安嘅措施，確保國家主席嘅人身安全，以及咧係相關活動能夠喺安全、有秩序同埋穩妥嘅情況之下進行。警方咧明白市民大眾都好關注國家主席係出席慶典活動嘅情況，而傳媒亦都有需要係進行呢一個採訪同埋報導，因此警方係會根據風險評估、保安嘅要求同埋場地限制等等嘅因素，以及喺唔影響警方行動嘅前提之下咧，盡力係去協助傳媒進行採訪。有關主席參與慶典活動嘅時候，會場裏邊嘅傳媒採訪安排，政府嘅新聞處同埋相關嘅部門會負責統籌同埋協調，亦都會適時對外發布官方嘅片段同埋資料。至於喺會場外面嘅範圍，警方會喺保安區入邊特別設立採訪區，方便傳媒喺場外進行採訪。期間，為咗確保公共安全同埋公共秩序，以及出席活動人士嘅安全，我哋係有需要核實進出採訪區記者嘅身份，並對佢哋一啲隨身嘅物品咧進行安全嘅檢查。安全嘅檢查咧係會由警方嘅搜查隊負責，傳媒聯絡隊嘅同事咧亦都會從旁作出協調，目的係為咗保障大家嘅安全，希望大家都能夠配合現場警務人員嘅安排。警方喺今次行動特別調派咗超過100名傳媒聯絡隊嘅人員喺行動現場協助傳媒。 警察公共關係科的新聞室亦都會24小時運作，接受傳媒查詢。如果有需要，我哋都會透過社交媒體平台向公眾發放最新的資訊。警方重申，香港是一個自由的社會，言論和新聞自由是受到基本法和香港人權法案的保障。我們尊重各個傳媒機構和記者的採訪報導工作，亦都會在可行的情況之下盡量提供便利和協助。謝謝。
現在開始答問的環節，想提問的記者請先舉手，我的同事會遞個麥給你，那麻煩你講出你的所屬機構，每人最多問三條。麻煩前排第一行橙色衫的位記者。
你好啊，無線嘅。三條問題，第一條問題想問一下，其實警方而家係咪已經肯定啊習主席會親身出席典禮啦？咁另外第二樣嘢就係，如果最終習主席佢係以視像去現身，咁我哋即係警方有咁高規格嘅布防，會唔會即係有啲浪費咧？咁第三就係想問一下，目前點樣評估本港嘅風險級別同埋一啲評估？唔該。
好，多謝你嘅提問。咁啊，我哋而家嗰個嘅安保嘅安排咧，嗰個細節咧，其實咧都係咧預計咗咧，我哋國家主席咧係會來港出席呢個25周年嘅慶典活動，同埋咧第六屆政府嘅就職典禮。我哋亦都咧有同咧我哋嘅相關單位咧係保持密切嘅聯繫。如果咧有任何嘅更新嘅話咧，我哋咧都會作出相應的調節，我們會以盡量減少對市民影響為我們的主題。好了，至於講到就是怎樣評估現在的風險級別，我們警隊一向都有一套是很完善的風險評估的機制，我們也有向海外和我們內地的情報單位是不時交換情報，作出咧適時嘅風險評估。咁到今日為止咧，我哋香港嚟講咧，冇具體嘅情報咧，係顯示咧，我哋香港會受到恐怖襲擊嘅威脅。咁所以咧，我哋喺香港而家嚟講嗰個風險級別咧，係維持喺中度嘅。咁但係就住主席出席我哋嘅嚟香港出席呢個25周年嘅慶典，同埋第六屆政府嗰個就職典禮嚟講咧，這個安排咧，我哋都有做一個風險評估，亦都係不時去更新。喺呢度嚟講咧，因為呢個地緣嘅政治啦嚇，國際嘅形勢，我哋國家主席咧嚟香港出席呢個活動咧，一定會係世界嘅焦點。可能大家都留意到，我哋香港咧近年咧本土恐怖主義嗰個冒聲咧，是明顯是具體的。我們過去的兩年間，在香港我們警隊破獲的與恐怖這些本土恐怖主義活動有關的案件，所找到的槍支、所找到的炸藥或者它的原材料，其實都是在外國不同的恐怖襲擊活動裡面用的武器是相類似的。因為是這樣，我們是高度關注今次主席嚟香港出席呢啲活動，佢會受到恐怖襲擊個威脅。
好，下一條啊。喺前邊第二行第一位女記者。
係，你好，我係香港零一嘅。咁就想問翻啦，警方就話即係冇收到任何示威活動嘅申請啦。咁今年都其實都冇七日遊行嘅。咁再加埋國安法其實實施咗啦。咁今次頭先都講到即係嗰個恐襲風險都係中度嘅。咁即係今次領導人訪港嗰個評估係咪可控嘅範圍之內啦？咁同埋對上一次20周年就有近萬嘅警員啦。咁今次會動員幾多嘅警力去候命咧？咁同埋就想問翻，即係今次嗰個封閉範圍啦，咁即係呢一個圍園需唔需要封閉咧？咁同埋核心保安區同埋保安區嘅範圍係幾大咧？咁同埋即係如果路過或者係著黑衫出現嘅話，會唔會都係唔闖禁區咧？唔該。
好， OK， 咁啊，多謝你嘅問題先啊。咁啊，頭先第一個問題，我係啦。咁你講示威嗰個申請啦。咁啊，首先我哋警方咧一向咧都係尊重咧我哋香港市民咧呢個言論自由、集會示威嘅自由權利，亦都咧我哋一向咧都有採取適當嘅措施咧去保障佢呢個咁嘅權利。但係咧，今次國家主席嚟香港出席呢啲個活動嘅時候咧，我哋警方係有責任，頭先都講過，要確保佢嘅人身安全，亦都要確保佢出席嘅慶典活動或者相關活動咧，都係要有安全、有序咁樣進行。亦都係因為咁嘅原因咧，我哋咧就喺我哋主席佢會逗留啦、到訪啦，或者佢嘅車隊途經嘅地方咧，我哋會設立咗核心嘅保安區同埋呢個保安區。咁我哋嗰個市民如果進行呢個公眾活動嘅時候咧，頭先我哋都講過，我會喺我保安區嘅旁邊就會設置一個咧公眾嘅活動區。我哋係平衡咗我哋個責任，我哋要確保主席喺香港出席活動時候嘅人身安全，個典禮要係安全有序嘅進行嘅時候，亦都平衡咗我哋市民嗰個權利。去進行佢嗰個嘅示威活動嘅時候咧，我哋都設置咗一個公共嘅活動區喺度，亦都會係派咗適當嘅警務人員，包括我哋嘅地區個嘅警民聯係主任咧，都會喺嗰度咧協助咧示威人士咧去進行佢個活動。頭先你問到啦，咁啊嗰個核心保安區有幾大啦嚇？咁咧呢個核心保安區同埋保安區嗰個範圍咧，其實咧。是要經過風險評估去決定的。這個風險評估呢，就會是去參考我們的主席出席那個活動的地點、那個時間，究竟它的地理環境是怎樣，有什麼人士出席那個活動，還有就是說如果要進行襲擊，究竟可以進行襲擊的模式又是什麼來的，一籃子因素底下呢，我們去作出一個風險評估以去定立核心保安區同埋保安區嗰個範圍。再講咧，核心保安區同埋保安區咧，唔係一個固定不變嘅限個範圍嚟，係要係會隨住我哋國家主席佢嘅變佢嘅走動而會有唔同，亦都咧係會因應我哋主席出席嘅活動嗰個嘅行程啦，或者個活動個安排嘅改變咧而有所調整。所以嚟講咧。所以嚟講咧，我哋咧呢個核心保安區同埋保安區咧，都係一個短暫嘅措施。一般情況嘅時候咧，市民其實咧係可以自由進出呢個保安區嘅，但係核心保安區咧係需要經過咧核實身份，同埋咧經過呢個我哋保安嘅安檢，先至可以去進入。
呢一邊中間第二行黑色衫嗰邊。
Assistant Commissioner, I'm from RTHK. At the moment, there are no words that whether President Xi Jinping will actually come to Hong Kong. Will there be any difference to police's security plan if the President at the end decided not to visit Hong Kong? Secondly, you also mentioned that the entire Hong Kong will be listed as a no-fly zone for drones. Is the coverage proportionate to the police security need? And finally, the League of Social Democrats said they are not going to hold any protests on July the 1st after the National Security Police invited them for a talk. Did the police in any way discourage any group to organize protest on July 1st? Thank you.
Okay, thank you for your question. We are planning our security operation and implementing the series of security measures. We are actually doing that in the preparation of our president physically visiting Hong Kong to attend the official events and the inauguration of the sixth term government ceremony. I've said before, we are actually maintaining close contact with our counterparts
okay, making sure the latest updates. And if there is any latest changes in our president's visits program, we will correspondingly adjust our security measures and deployment in order to reduce or to minimize the inconvenience caused to members of public. That is also our important concern. Regarding the question of restricted flying zone for the drone, for the unmanned aircraft, first of all, after the implementation of the new legislation, the Chapter 448G, okay, in the new legislation, Section 19, actually the law confer the power to the Commissioner of Police to designate certain area of Hong Kong as restricted flying zone if the purpose of which is connected to the performance of our police duties in accordance with the Police Force Ordinance, Section 10. And we decide to use the power to designate the whole area of Hong Kong as restricted flying zone is based on risk assessment. The risk assessment actually includes, we make reference to the overseas and the mainland where the president's state leader will participate in the program and the reference of the size of the restricted flying zones for the drones. That's one. And we also make reference to the overseas drones attack to the state leader's visit program, as well as to the critical infrastructure. We also make reference to the technology advancement of the drones nowadays. And also we make reference to our latest intelligence. Because the activities or the itinerary of our president's program, we need to keep it confidential. And therefore, in order to balance the rights of the people to use drones and our responsibility to ensure the personal safety of our president during his stay in Hong Kong, the decision is, we consider it's a well balance of the two needs, right? Okay, for your third question, okay, protests of the, okay, again, right, I've stated that, right, we fully respect the rights of people, the freedom of expression, the freedom of staging protests, demonstration, public meetings, etc. And we also taken reasonable measures to ensure these rights are protected. Also in the security operation, I mentioned before, we also introduced designated public activities area just outside our security zone. The measure, again, is a balance of the people's rights to stage public meetings, processions, and our responsibility to make sure the personal safety of our presidents. Thank you.
Okay, 下一題，前面第一行格仔三個位林記者。
你好，明報幾個問題，首先想問一下，謝文烈就話即係國安處有建咗佢哋啦，咁請問其實約談嘅內容係啲乜嘢啦？警方又有冇約見其他嘅團體咧？咁如果嗰日咧有啲嘅團體喺保安區一帶去進行一啲公眾集會，你哋會點處理啦？咁第二就想問一下咧，近日就國安處拘捕咗多人啦，加上中環槍擊案嗰個涉案嘅槍械其實就未揾翻啦，有冇話其實因應呢啲事件咧，嗰個保安嘅風險增加咗啦？咁同埋有冇一啲情報？ 顯示就話即係習近平比起五年前嚟講嘅時候，嗰個恐襲嘅風險又有提升到咧。咁最尾就想問一下咧，即係有啲消息就話即係習近平就會去視察呢個三跑同埋科學園啦。咁警方喺嗰一帶有冇一啲嘅安保工作啦？咁啱啱講到話安保工作咧，出入嘅人都會有一啲嘅安檢啦。咁如果有啲人士係戴咗遮啦，又或者一啲有標語嘅裝飾咧，又係容唔容許入去嘅咧？唔該。 好嘅，多謝記者問題啊。咁啊，好啦，關於就係係啦，社民連嗰個情況啦。咁啊，第一就頭先我都重複講咗，咁其實我哋香港警方咧，由始至終咧都係尊重咧市民咧遊行集會言論自由個權利。我哋咧喺今次嘅保安行動裏面咧，其實咧我哋都係有設置咗一個適當嘅措施。去保障到市民呢一個表達佢嘅言論，去進行佢嘅集會示威嘅權利。咁頭先我都講過，因為今次呢個係一個安保嘅行動，國家主席嚟香港咧，我哋係有責任要去確保佢嘅人身安全，亦都係有責任我要咧確保咧主席出席嘅所有嘅慶典活動係能夠咧係有序安全個底下去進行。在咁樣嘅平衡嘅時候咧，我哋就作出咗，我哋設置咗適當嘅公眾活動區喺適當嘅位置，去俾市民能夠一方面能夠表達到佢哋想表示嘅示威嘅權利，亦都同樣時間咧，都令到我哋警方咧能夠係做到我哋嘅工作，能夠係完成到我哋嘅責任，去確保主席咧嘅人身安全，亦都個活動咧係能夠係有序安全咁進行。中環槍擊案嗰個情況啦嚇，咁咧冇錯，咁啊嗰個我哋而家呢個案件，其實昨天其實我哋都有同事嚇，即係都做咗個記者招待會，解釋咗佢嗰個進度啦，係嘛，再拘捕嘅人士。咁係我諗我主要答就個風險評估。頭先我都講過，其實我哋喺採納去做一個風險評估咧，其實我哋考慮嘅因素咧都係一籃子。中環槍擊案嘅槍支未揾到呢個咧，都係我哋考慮裡面的系列之一嚟。OK， 咁所以頭先我講到就係話，雖然暫時嚟講咧未有具體嘅情報，香港咧係受到恐怖襲擊，所以我哋維持咧係中度。但係就住主席咧去嚟香港出席活動裡面嚟講，頭先我都講過，我哋本土恐怖主義嗰個冒聲係嘛？我一個最近呢幾年我哋揾到嘅槍支啊、炸藥，甚至乎原材料，全部都係我哋擔心，全部都係我哋關注。OK， 呢啲咧，亦都係令到我哋點解會講，我對於國家主席今次咧嚟香港出席活動裏面咧，我哋係好高度關注咧，佢對受到恐怖襲擊嗰個威脅。三跑，係 OK， 係啦，三跑。OK， 咁咧就嗱，就住嘅國家主席嗰個嘅行程啦，嗰個活動咧，其實頭先我都講過，我哋咧係有責任要去保密。OK， 亦都呢個咁樣做咧，係確保到咧我呢個保安行動咧係能夠可以做得到，去確保到佢嘅人身安全，亦都係嚇，因為我要確保佢嗰個出席嘅活動係有序安全進行，所以我就係唔可以透露。
好，下一題。前面第三行間條 T 恤嗰位女記者，
你好啊！香港電台啊，首先就想問一下，其實頭先都有講到話，喺保安區入面，市民都係可以自由出入嗰個保安區啦。咁但係就想問一下，即係都跟進翻頭先行家問題先，就係、是、如果市民可能著住黑色衫或者係黃色口罩嘅，你都會唔會即係有一啲行動，或者係會唔會都即係加強嗰個截查咧？另外就想問一下，其實近日咧都有啲即係國旗啊、區旗啊，即係都懷疑被焚毀啊、塗鴉嘅案件啦。當日嗰兩日都會可能好多地方都會有呢、這、一個國旗區旗掛咗喺度嘅，會唔會都加強個部署同埋嗰個搜證同埋執法過程，會唔會都有啲困難咁樣？唔該。
好，咁啊就住你講嘅喺保安區嗰、那個那個情況啦嚇。咁頭先我都講過，咁啊其實保安區同埋核心保安區咧，其實唔係一個固定不變嘅地方嚟嘅。OK， 係咧因應咧就係我哋嘅國家主席。其實佢嗰陣時嗰個嘅流走動啊，那個行程，其實佢先去設置嘅。咁頭先我都講到啦，咁有啲情況咧，其實咧嗰、那個保安區咧，其實係市民咧係可以自由即係出入嘅。OK， 咁係去到特定嘅情況之下咧，我哋要將個保安區咧可能要有人流啦同埋車流嘅管制。咁我哋到時喺現場係有警務人員咧係會協助市民清楚話俾佢知道，而家呢個情況係要有個短暫嚇嘅人流或者車輛嘅管制，咁希望佢哋會去合作啦嚇。 咁至於你講到就係話頭先你講服飾嗰個問題啦，咁呢、這個你而家咁樣問咧，咁我其實好難即係一下就答咗你。咁你喺保安區穿著一啲特別嘅服飾，咁呢個咧即係我哋就要考慮當其時嗰個情況，究竟嗰個服飾同嗰個情況，因為嗰個始終都係個保安區。係啦，咁點解佢會著咗一啲即係與其他人唔同嘅一啲嘅服飾嘅咧嚇？係唔係佢有一個特別嘅意圖咧？係嘛？咁我哋咧同時咧，我哋警務人員咧一定咧係會去向佢作出調查啦。究竟了解下究竟佢個意圖係做乜嘢啦？佢係經過啊，定係其實佢本身係想進行一啲示威活動？如果係嘅話咧，係後者嘅話咧，咁我哋係同時係會咩咧？係會同佢解釋，甚至乎咧係協助佢帶佢去咧。適當的嗰個公眾活動區咧，進行佢嘅活動。至於你講近日國旗嗰個區旗係啦，燒毀案啦，係啦，咁啊係冇錯。咁其實咧，你大家睇到其實我哋香港好多個市民其實都好熱烈、好期盼我哋嘅國家主席咧喺今次今年喺25周年回歸25周年嚟出席呢個活動咧，我哋好期盼、好開心、好雀躍咁去歡迎佢嚟。所以咧喺唔同嘅地區咧都掛咗，譬如我哋國旗啊、區旗咁，好靚。但係你見到啲有心人亦都喺度製造破壞啦。咁咧即係我相信我想喺度講，第一就係其實我都可以喺呢度譴責呢啲咁嘅人，呢啲咁樣嘅行為。我哋咧一定咧係同呢啲人咧勢不兩立。我哋而家咧區嘅案隊咧係積極係調查緊呢啲案件，佢哋咧會有跟進。我都希望。好快有好消息，去話到俾大家記者朋友知道，我哋將相關嘅人士繩之於法。
下一題，前邊第二行白色衫嗰位女記者，
你好 K 寶嘅，想問幾條問題啦。第一就係啲封閉措施同埋禁令。大概去到幾時會完結呢？即係你剛才所講到嘅，例如係封閉會展站啊，又或者係巴士改道啊、封路啊、封閉行人天橋呢啲，會去到幾時完結呢？同埋點解要禁全港嘅無人機呢？第三條問題就係啱啱提到會場外面啦，有傳媒嘅採訪區，咁目前會場裏邊會唔會都有另外嘅？採訪區俾傳媒去即有冇傳媒係獲准入會展嘅咧？唔該曬。
咁有三條問題啦。咁咧就嗱關於港島區嗰個封路嗰個安排行嗰、那個事情咧，我就交翻俾阿廖 Sir 稍後作答。咁另外你講採訪區嗰個情況咧，我一陣間交俾阿郭 Sir 答。咁我就即先答你關於無人機點解要香港頭先問我話全個香港無人要限飛區啦，係咪？係啦。咁或者我都再講一次啦。咁首先我哋今次去設立香港全個香港係小型無人機嘅限飛區，喺國家主席出席活動期間咧，呢個係第一係根據法例去做。OK， 我哋係有法所依嘅，係根據而家新嘅小型無人機條例第19条嗰度當中咧係賦予咗咧我哋警務處處長咧。可以係因應咧，我哋去執行我哋警隊條例嘅第10条，我哋警務職責嘅情況底下咧，我哋可以將香港某個範圍嘅地方咧，係設立為一個小型無人機嘅限飛區。咁我哋今次咁樣設立全香港為一個小型無人機嘅限飛區咧，其實我哋經過一個好謹慎嘅風險評估之後而作出。咁當中咧係包括我哋有參考過喺國外。國內我哋嘅國家主席或者元首所出席活動咧，佢哋去設置無人機嘅限飛區嗰個範圍，我哋亦都有咧參考過近年咧喺海外利用小型無人機去策動嘅襲擊，無論係襲擊個國家元首，無論係襲擊嗰個地方嘅一啲重要基礎設施，我哋亦都有參考到咧，就係話近年咧。無人機科技嗰個發展嗰個進步，佢嘅載重量、佢個續行力等等，我哋都有咧，就係參考到咧，就係我哋國家主席如果出席活動裏面咧，個地點、個地理環境。咁頭先我都講過，因為咧佢出席嘅活動嘅行程同埋活動安排咧，我哋係有責任去保密。咁所以咧喺平衡咗市民。去用無人機嗰個權利， 同埋平衡咗，我哋有個責任要去確保主席喺香港出席活動嘅時候咧，嗰、那個嘅人身安全啦，同埋個活動能夠係有序同埋咧係安全地嘅情況底下進行咧，我哋作出呢個決定。我哋認為呢個決定咧係一個最好嘅平衡。由阿郭 Sir 先講
呢、這個採訪安排啊嘛。係啦，咁啊，就住呢一個嘅傳媒採訪安排咧，的而且確咧，特區政府都係好重視新聞自由啦。咁所以都明白到咧，其實傳媒同埋記者都係有需要去做採訪嘅。咁誒，剛才其實開始嘅時候都有介紹過啦。鑑於咧喺嗰個嘅活動嘅會場入邊嗰個採訪安排咧，其實主要就係由翻政府新聞處同埋相關嘅部門咧係負責統籌同埋協調嘅。佢較早前亦都已經作出咗一啲邀請啦，就係俾傳媒嘅同事咧就去做採訪啦。咁誒而過程當中咧，佢哋都會考慮好多嘅因素嘅。咁誒除咗話佢哋會俾傳媒去採訪之外咧，佢哋都會有一啲官方嘅傳媒嘅安排，亦都會發放一啲嘅官方嘅片段啊資料俾大家。咁而我哋警方咧亦都會配合住政府新聞處啦，同埋相關部門嗰個採訪嘅安排咧，而作出適當嘅調配。確保咧就大家能夠可以做到你哋嘅工作，去做到傳媒採訪嘅工作嘅。
係有關你頭先提到啦啲封閉嘅措施啦，咁喺我哋行動上咧，其實我哋係都係攞翻個平衡啦。一方面係一個安全嘅需要啦，喺成個安保行動裏邊，咁另外亦都其實我哋都係好重視即係佢會唔會對市民啊造成一啲不便？咁我哋其實今次成個安排咧，其實我哋都明白係一定會令到啲市民咧，可能係會等耐咗啊，行多咗啊咁樣。呢、這個我哋係會一路會睇住個情況啦。咁一係可以嘅時候咧，我哋就會咧係取消翻嗰啲封閉嘅措施嘅。咁呢個咧亦都提醒翻市民啦，留意翻我哋最新嘅包括我哋警方或者其他相關部門發出嘅一啲最新嘅公佈。
前面第一行藍色恤衫嗰位男記者，唔該。
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for doing this. My name is Atsushi Okudera from Asahi Shimbun, Japanese newspaper. First of all, about the quarantine, the police official is going to have another quarantine before President Xi Jinping is coming. Or if so, how many days and how many people is going to have another quarantine?The second of all, as you mentioned, you know, the itinerary is not going to be disclosed because of the security of President Xi Jinping. But just asking, you know, airport or the highway or the railway station is also is going to be the target for the security measure, security arrangement. If so, you're going to close this kind of facility in coming few days. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you for your question. Okay, regarding the quarantine measure, okay, yes, right, it is the requirement of the relevant authority that, right, for those attending as guests, right, to the 25th anniversary ceremony,or the inauguration of the sixth term government of the Hong Kong SAR ceremony. For those guests, including the top government officials, they are required to undergo quarantine arrangement. I think you have read from the newspaper, not just staying in the hotel, you know, they also need to conduct, you know, a variety of different measures, including, you know, the PCR tests, etc.Okay, that is actually, you know, all in the requirements as stipulated, right, by the authority. Okay, to those, right, guests, including top government officials, even the government working staff, right, for those needs to enter the venues, right, need to undergo, you know, certain quarantine arrangement or measures.
Including police officers, including security personnel, including
yes.
private.
As I said, right, the quarantine requirement or the measures, right, actually, you know, is the relevant authority requirement, right, of all the guests, right, government officials attending as guests, and also government staff, right, working
inside the venue, right? And they are required to undergo the quarantine arrangement. And yeah, regarding your question of our president's itinerary. As I said before, for the security arrangement, one of the characteristics right here is, and we set up core security zone and security zone. The core security zone and the security zone is not fixed, okay, as such, right? It's very, in accordance with the itinerary and the activities of our president's visit or stays or his motorcade passes by, then certain areas will be treated or designated as core security zone and security zone temporarily. And doing our president's such as passes by or the venue he visits, etc., then we will set up the temporary core security zone and security zone. And during that period of time, we will have measures in place, right, to regulate traffic, to regulate pedestrian. And we will have police officers at scene to give clear instruction to members of public to comply with the temporary requirements. Thank you.
最後兩條問題了。
剛才我都講過，這個安排係平衡咗
在我們的警察的責任，去要在我們國家主席來香港的時候，我要我們的責任要保護，確保他的人身安全，亦都要確保他出席的活動的地方的時候是要有安全有序進行。我們在這個平衡底下，我們就在我們的保安區 OK 的外面就立刻設立一個公眾的活動，好讓我們市民呢是繼續去有這個權利去表達他的言論的自由的地方。好了，就著你問那個是啦，主席今次這個沒錯，我們今次的保安安排呢，其實呢是我們是預計我們的主席呢是會來講出席活動 而去安排而去我們 去設置的一連串的安保的措施。咁頭先我都講過啦，其實我哋都同我哋嘅對口單位咧係保持密切嘅溝通。如果有任何嚇好突如其來嘅改變嘅話咧，其實我哋都會適當嘅作出咧係跟進同埋安排。頭先我都講過，我哋一向咧都係會以減少影響市民咧為我哋嘅宗旨。好啦，咁啊嗰個封路嗰度咧，咁我交俾阿廖 Sir 幫我作答啦。
係，唔該啊，女 Sir。咁啊，其實我哋每一次即係封路嗰個安排咧，咁其實我哋個考慮都有好多，好小心去考慮每一樣嘢。咁特別阿 Sir 提到會唔會對市民個影響有幾大啊咁樣。咁但係當然亦都要平衡翻安全需要啦。咁事實上其實每一次我哋考慮嘅情況咧，你會見到都唔同嘅。譬如而家今次嘅路面嘅情況啦，喺路面上面嘅設施啦，喺整個道路嘅網絡咧，其實都有好大嘅轉變。咁事實上亦都唔能夠同以往嘅一啲情況去做一啲比較啊。唔該曬。
好，再一提，這個第二行第一個男記者。
你好，點新聞嘅，我哋有兩條問題啦。咁即係現時咧，雖然冇大規模呢個動亂啦，但係咧對於一啲即係孤狼式嘅襲擊行為咧，警方將如何防範咧？譬如話唔係針對呢個領導人嘅，譬如話可能喺七一當日啦，針對一啲普通市民啊呢啲嘅可能會有個恐襲行為啦，點樣防範啦？咁第二條問題咧就係警隊咧喺七月一日咧會採用呢個中式步操啦，包括呢個七一嘅升旗儀式咧。咁對於呢個警隊咧有咩意義啦？希望傳達出咩嘅信息咧？唔該。
未開咪 sorry 啊，就住你講嗰個七一步操嗰個問題咧，咁啊應該稍後咧就阿郭 Sir 會幫我作答啦。好啦，OK， 咁你而家講到就話，即係另外一條問題就話，香港冇大規模嘅即係示威動亂啦，係嘛？咁啊點樣預防孤狼式嗰個恐怖襲擊？我真係好多謝你呢個問題。咁其實我都頭先都講過，即係好幾次。其實咧，我哋香港其實而家咧最其中好關注嘅就係咧本土個恐怖主義個冒聲。係嘛？頭先我都講過，其實咧係即係過去嘅年間係嘛，就算乎係呢幾個月係咪咁？大家我諗我哋都係香港嘅市民，我相信大家咧都會同我一樣嘅感覺，見到中環槍擊案係嘛，見到喺係嘛五月份喺黃大仙係嘛，我哋能夠搜到咁多即係爆炸品嘅原材料，我相信大家都會係同我一樣係擔心係嘛？嗰啲頭先我都講過，呢啲揾到個槍支，揾到個爆炸品嘅原材料。其實咧喺外國嘅恐怖襲擊，佢哋施襲嘅時候嘅武器咧係類近。咁呢個係講緊乜嘢咧？即係講緊咧，其實咧呢個咁樣嘅本土恐怖主義咧，其實係好具體、好明顯。我哋其實係唔係淨係單靠我警方一方面嘅力量咧，係可以解決呢個問題。亦都唔係淨係單靠我政府咧，係可以解決到呢個問題。頭先我都講過，我都喺度再呼籲啦。其實我哋要咩全民反恐。係咪啊？我哋都講到，我哋要見而即報。只要係有呢個力量咧，我相信咧，呢個本土恐怖主義咧係會受到控制。好，我交俾阿郭 Sir。
係咁啊，就住中式步操方面啦，咁啊，香港就回歸祖國25周年啦。其實我哋同內地嗰個嘅交流接觸咧，一直都係越嚟越頻繁嘅。喺過去嘅時間都感受到啦，即係國家對於香港發展嗰個全力嘅支持同埋協助啦。咁我哋其實喺警隊步操方面咧，其實都係與時並進嘅，同其他嘅訓練項目都一樣。咁啊，過去嘅日子咧，其實我哋都不斷去完善我哋步操嘅方式啦。由以往嘅港式步操咧，嚟緊我哋係會真係喺全面咧喺嚟緊嘅七月一號咧，就全面推行呢一個中式步操。 而家過一年咧，我哋都不斷係做咗相關嘅訓練噶啦，即係無論係新入職嘅同事啦、現職嘅同事啦、我哋輔警嘅同事啦，係都就住嗰個步操嘅即係轉變咧，而做咗一系列嘅訓練嗰個安排，甚至乎亦都做咗一啲嘅電子嘅教材咧，係俾我哋同事去參考。目的都係希望能夠喺7月1日全面即係推行呢一個中式步操嘅時間咧，都能夠同事有一個好專業嘅表現，能夠將呢個步操嗰個表現做得最好。咁呢都反映咗咧，我哋即係對國家嗰個愛國嘅情懷啦。我都期望能夠可以透過中式步操咧，係展現俾我哋嘅全港市民知道嘅。
好，今日記者會結束，多謝大家出席。